So I think we can mention several key factors, which is starts the first one. First of all, it is procurement buyers. Procurement teams are not sourcing not only locally right now. It is just the sourcing market is expanded globally, and the globalization is one of the first key factors. Secondly is the technology development, which is already mentioned in the sessions as well in the other interviews. The AI technology, the development in the technology area is the second key factor. And growing focus on sustainability and ethical sourcing is one of the other factors, because it is like that corporate responsibility, sustainable sourcing is one of the key factors in the companies. And building and maintaining suppliers strong relationship with the suppliers, because they are now in the nowadays, if we talk about the decades, last decade in compared to business partners to us. So therefore, it should be handled in a very careful way. And risk management, I mean, as we all know, the pandemic changed the world, but it's not just the pandemic. It is there are lots of happening each and every day all over the world. Since the globalization is one of the key factors in the sourcing area, such as Red Sea situation nowadays in the logistic area, that all the companies in Europe and all over the world needs to rethink their supply chain activities. Skill and education. If we say in the last 4 to 5 years, I can see an incredible amount of attention from procurements and supply chain team professional focusing on their education, certifications on the procurement areas, supply chain areas. There are more faculties, department at the university in the terms of area. And as the last one that I can mention is procurement departments are the shining stars for the organizations, because now the cost pressure in the competitive world, it brings our value to the surface. Let me phrase like that. It's just not like anymore taking three offers and release the order. It is just the procurement colleagues all over the world adding value to the supply chain organization. And these are the key factors. It is like since we, I mean, I am also in the procurement area, therefore I am calling we are the strategic function to achieve business goals for the organizations. Therefore, the procurement success is now related with the business success as well. It's not just the one chain in the supply chain, but we are bringing value to the organization. And with the end-to-end sourcing perspective, they are now buyers are now taking extra mile in terms of understanding the need, going deeply. How is the specification? How is the each and every step till the end of the sourcing? So therefore, team success is related with the business. Therefore, this is the one of the key area. Let me say like that. And technology wise. Technology development brings us a very easiness in our daily life, such as the AI business effect on the tail management system, so-called tail management spent in the procurement area. The teams are able to focus on more high volume spend. Therefore, it is focusing on high volume spend brings more capacity on the high volume spend brings more savings to the company. And we mentioned that ethical and sustainable sourcing. This is also another key factor, because sustainability definition is not just for the corporates, it's also in the daily life of to everyone. And if the higher awareness of the procurement teams brings more, let's say, green sourcing or ethical sourcing on the alignment of the corporate guidelines, legal conditions of the countries. All of them are a success factor for the teams. It is not just a function in the organization, which is also brings an opportunity for the procurement teams to develop their SAMs cross-functional in the corporates. That means they can move to marketing area, they can move to consulting area, supply chain area. In terms of development within the company, also in terms of cross-functional, they can move. And they are just feeling better because we are not just the guys to approve the final step on the system. We feel like bringing values to the organization with the total cost of ownership approach, and what we bring on the table has an effect in the financials of the company. So this is also the highlights of the team is more visible from the management side now. Therefore, the feeling better. This is one of the opportunities, and I think that also the one of the major ones. But if we mention the challenges, so it is not just like the final approval. If we go more deep into organization, we are having also more. We are facing more problems in the organization, such as in the supply chain. So, this is one of the things. And we have a more data, as usual, in all of the areas. Then the analytic approach is harder than the previous years. And this the risk management is also a challenge because globally sourcing most of the companies. Doing the sourcing globally across all countries, and that means the problems are globally as well. So if something happens in China, it has effect in Turkey. Türkiye, if in the Middle East, there is a new regulation on, let's say, sustainability, then we need to change our policy as well. So these are the challenges, I would say, and the opportunities is teams are can grow easily. The attractiveness of the procurement is higher than the previous years, and the visibility in the procurement area is much more better. And the final thing I would mention that the growth possibility as a person, as a personally for the teams, because if you are doing marketing procurement, you are in a marketing business, and this is priceless. If you are 2 years later, if you do services procurement, then you are a business administration expert. But you learn all of the stuff for a company. So, consultancy in procurement, I think it should be handled very gently because in some areas procurement needs to be very careful. It's not just the cost. If we are mentioning the ground basis of the procurement, the first lessons or advice to I would like to give my peers or colleagues in the team, you need to focus on total cost of ownership. So it is not just the cost. It is also the after services, the value of the service, what you are buying in terms of goods or services, and what for are you buying, what is the need. If you spend, let's say, some certain amount of the money into the consultings, but what will be the output? What will be the effect? You need to measure it. If you know how to measure it, then it's not, this is the best, one of the best examples for the TCO approach, right? That's the question. You just to find the right one. Which consultant?